Last video, I showed you that I was basically just drilling out the coin box. Well, I want to show you the mechanics of this, okay? So for this project, you're going to need a decent electric drill. Don't use a hammer drill, use a regular drill. You're going to need a big ass screwdriver and a quarter inch drill bit. Maybe you can go up one size as well too if you need to. So the first thing I did, and a lot of people had a problem with this, they didn't understand here what I meant by taking and opening up this gap. You need to open up this little protection slot right here. This actually originally was just a slot, a narrow slot, so you had enough room to actually get the key in and unlock it. Okay, well, you can't get the drill bit in, and if you tried to stick a drill bit in there, it would actually just sit and spin this little slot here, and that's supposed to do that because you can't break into the, you know, it helps so you don't break into the lock assembly. But what I did is I took a big snap-on screwdriver, and these are, I think, one of the biggest ones you can get, and I don't really know the model number, it's in my other video. And what I did is I went and I just went back and forth, and I would just keep driving the pushing the screwdriver in, and I'd go back and forth, and I had to get pretty violent with it. But when actually the lock is actually in here, you know, it's pretty easy to do because you've got all of this leverage here on this, and the actual vault is actually holding this box still. So just get in there and waller that sucker out. Just go back and forth. Don't be afraid. Okay, you got really nothing to lose. Okay, next thing, you put this on a drill. This is a quarter inch bit, all right? And you go through here and you just drill. And you can go at a medium speed, let the drill do its job. I gotta tell you, you want a good quality sharp drill bit on this. No dull bits. Even if you have to, it's worth going to the hardware store and picking up a new set of bits or a new quarter inch bit. And what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna drill this out. You can't really see the shavings coming out because they're actually collecting inside this cup. But you'll notice yourself, you go through, and this is gonna take 2, 3 minutes, maybe 4 minutes, kind of depending on how your drill is functioning and how sharp the drill bit is. But the overall objective is you want to drill, and you're gonna drill out through the back of the lock here, okay? And what they have in here is they have a nut, okay? And what you're gonna do is when you get to a certain point here, with your drill bit, the nut's just gonna actually just pop out. So the nut and the little stud is actually just gonna pop into the box. Now, another thing you need to remember is you've got to open this cam. This is how they open. When you turn the lock, see, it opens that cam. And you have the little side piece that comes out and, you know, locks into here, okay? So, on one of the boxes, I just happened to luck out, and in drilling, I unlocked the cam, and so that worked out fine. On another one of the boxes, the other one, I ended up going in with a little bit smaller screwdriver, and I had to go in and work it so I could actually get the cam to move. And actually to close, okay? All right, now, another thing that a lot of people have asked me about was, well, now how do you get the lock? Okay, so I looked up the lock on the internet, and if you can find one, I found one place that wanted like 60 bucks for a lock and to repair it. There's a guy doing a video on how to replace this actual lock assembly. Screw that. You can go on the internet and order this box. And this is a UG800A. All right. And what I did is I ordered a set of them. These suckers go for $35 a piece. It was either $35 or $38 a piece. This is with everything. You only get one key. It's pretty standard just to get one key. And you get the coin box. Hold on a second, and I will give you the information on where to buy this. Okay, so I bought this from Reliable Parts, and these guys were down in Seattle, Washington, and they were, let's see here, about 35 bucks a pop, $35.53, and applicable tax and shipping. I think they charged $9 flat rate shipping. Reliable Parts was absolutely awesome. I ordered these parts on like a Tuesday, around lunchtime, and they were on my doorstep the next morning. So that was freaking awesome. If they have it in stock, they'll get it to you pretty quickly. Now, the box is the same box. The configuration of the box here, all these dimensions are the same. What they've done, and I don't know if this is an update or if they got cheesy, I don't really know what the deal was, but they just changed to a cylinder type lock instead. Okay, so you got these little goofy keys. Okay, now remember, you only get one key. So, inside the box is the number of the key. Okay, record that. All right, also, you have the number of the key actually stamped on the key. The reason why I say record that is, if you ever have your keys stolen, or you lose your keys, you can go back, get that number, and then order the key from a supplier like Greenwald, I guess. I mean, they're just spendy if you go to the factory. You can go to Reliable Parts or just look them up on the internet. And the reason why I had to break into my laundromat in the first place was the keys were actually stolen, and I did not write the key code down in my manual when I bought the washer and dryer unit. So I recommend to write those key codes down so you do not have to break into that again. But there you go. All right, I hope that this answers all of your questions, and thank you for watching, and I hope this helps you, laundromat guys, because this is spendy stuff, man. I mean, I've seen these keys sell for like 30 bucks, 25 and 30 bucks on their own. But why do that when you get the whole new box and everything? You're just done. All right. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe. And y'all have a good one.